must be great riding with him.
Look out, look out, look out, look out!
Good morning, everybody, or good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're listening, watching from. Welcome to another Tales from the Bike Shed. So in the last video, and I do apologise, in the last video the camera angle for the engine on the freezer down there was absolutely crap, so I do apologise about that. Anyway, in this video we're going to be fitting the engine and try and keep it short and sweet. And without further ado, I've got to say, great news came through the post yesterday after paying customs charges. The new shock for the Rise, Andy boy, the Rise! There we go, DVO Air T3, DVO Air T, anyway, it's that one, and it's going in there. Right then, without further ado, let's crack on with this engine replacement thing. What's his face, in a bit. So there we go, I've taken the fairing off in preparation for checking the engine out. So all I have to do is take the gear shift off. That won't be going back on, I'll use a Lifan one. Disconnect the wires, disconnect the carb at the engine there and lift that all out. Don't need to disconnect the fuel because that is staying as is, I'll be using that carb. And then going down the other side, disconnect the horn, disconnect the exhaust, HT lead, keep that. Take the gear lever, the kickstart off, because that will be going back on, because the Lifan one is straight up, so it'll bash that and the exhaust. And yeah, just drop the exhaust down a bit. One engine mounting bolt there, one engine mounting bolt there with the back brake light switch, which is there. Disconnect that, undo the mounting bolt, which is there, and the engine will drop out. And that is it, that is as easy as it is. So what I might do though is swap my put this Honda casing onto the Lifan. I think that'll fit, but I need to take that off anyway to swap the no, I don't have to do anything, I just need to drop that, but I need to take that off to disconnect the chain so I can get the engine out. And I think that Honda casing will fit on the Lifan, so if that's the case, that is going on. And there we have it, engine out. It wasn't as easy as it's made out to be. It's easy, but it is a bit of a faff. Problem I did have getting it out, the exhaust manifold, it seized on and it cracked the exhaust at the manifold, so that needs a new exhaust, which is a pain in the ass. But yeah, it's pretty relatively straightforward. Bit of a bugger about the exhaust. It's so rusted, a little bit of pressure and bang, he cracked. All right, so there he is, the old one. Also, all I gotta do, just rest him there. Yeah, that's where he cracked just a little bit. This is completely seized in there, completely. And a bolt sheared when I was trying to undo him. Bit of wiggle there, it snapped straight off, clean as you like. So it's not as if it's an issue, because getting a new engine, putting a new engine in there, but it's something I will get fixed at some point. And there's the footrest and the side stand. Just undo the four bolts and drop that straight in. And there you go. I've checked the wires. All the wires match up, same colours. And that's it. Happy days, boys and girls, happy days. Then that's a 15. I'll be putting a 16 on the Lifan. And I'll keep the Lifan cover on, because it's nicer nick than that. Right then, peeps. Engineless scooter for the time being. Right then, get things cleaned up, and then I'm going to knock it on the head for the time being, and then come back at a later date and fit the new one in a bit. Right, so there we go, peeps. The engine is in. It was pretty straightforward, actually. I did rest it on some wooden blocks just to raise it up a bit, and then lift it up into the two mounting points from there. And it was pretty straightforward. I was quite impressed with that. I think I did see in one of the earlier videos that the Lifan comes with a 14 tooth sprocket. Well, it actually comes with a 15 tooth sprocket, which is the same standard size as the Honda engine. But I've now put the 16 tooth in, keeping the standard 39. I have got a new chain coming. Hopefully that'll be here tomorrow. Anyway, get that fitted. That one's a bit manky. So there we go. New one's in, the carb's on. Just got to wire it up, get everything wired up, and then take it from there. Right then, let's do the next stage, the wiring up bit. Right then, everybody, I've just wired him up. Everything's the same. There we go. All plugged in nice and snug. Let's get the ignition keys and see if everything is as it should be. So, ignition key in. Oh yes, we have a neutral light. Right, let's try the indicator. And the back end. Oh, lovely Andy boy. Left. Yep. And now let's see if this old baby's horny. Happy days, boys and girls, happy days. Let's crack on with the rest of it. Right, there's the new exhaust fitted. Nice and lovely, nice copper gasket in there. Swapped over the mounting bracket. Not bad, exhaust, 50 quid, eBay, delivered. That'll do the job, thank you very much. Right, and now we're gonna drop the transport engine oil. So it's a 17 mil spanner. There we go, dropping the transport oil. I'm not sure how much is in there, so we'll just let that drain. And then we'll put some proper 1040 motorcycle oil in there. Right, that's the engine, the transport engine oil drained. So let's get the plug back in. Nip that up. There we go. So this is the oil that I got sent from 7-1 Racing with the engine, and I'm gonna put that in. If it's good enough for them, it's good enough for me. Right, I think it's 800 millilitres of this. There we go. Right, I haven't got a funnel, so I'm gonna use a big Saturday Night Fun Boy syringe. Suck it out, suck it out. Oop, one. I'll just take a reading. See where he is at. So I've just got to put him into the top of the thread. Right, just a little squirt more, and that'll be him. I'll just check that now. Perfect, on the level. Right, clean that up, screw that back in. Excellent. And that was about 750 mil to get him to the level. Right then, folks, that's it. The engine is in, it's complete. Got a few little things just to finish it off. I'm gonna leave the cover off until I get the new chain. So that's gonna make life easy putting the new chain on. I'm gonna put the Lifan cover back on because of this little bit here. The Honda cover won't fit because of that bit there, so no drama. Right then. So just to recap, taking the engine out. So we have to make believe that this is the Honda. So to take it out, cover off, disconnect chain. Undo the carb, the two mounting bolts, lift the whole carb up and across, because that is going to get refitted. So that's that side. And don't forget your gear lever off. go around the other side. Disconnect the HT lead, disconnect your plug, carefully undo your exhaust manifold brackets, kickstart off, undo the swinging arm securing bolt for the motorcycle, the exhaust cover, and then just disconnect the rear brake springs and the rear brake switch. Once that's disconnected, you can then undo your top. Have I said take the kickstart off? Well, I have now. And then it's just undo your top mounting bolt, undo your your bottom mounting bolt, and then just gently drop him out, and that is it. And then it's just the reverse process going back in. Like I say, I bought the engine with the groove already in. If you don't, you're gonna have to swap your cover off. I took the foot pegs off when the engine was out and then swapped him over, and then that helped actually to lift him back in. Other than that, what have I done? That's it really. New exhaust after the other one broke. I've put a new iridium spark plug in. All the wires match up. So I'm just going to wait for the chain to turn up and then fit that, and then we can take him for a bit of a test ride around the yard. But I am now going to fire him up and see what's what. Oh, and don't forget to change the drop the oil, the transit oil. I thought it was a Honda or a Lifan. Anyway, drop the oil, the transportation oil, and drop some decent 1040 motorcycle oil in, which I have done. Use the 7-1 stuff. Thank you very much, Blaine, if you get to watch this. Appreciate all your help. It's in. Right then, I'm going to go for a startup. Oh, and I did forget one thing. One thing I have done, and this is what I've picked up from some of the people on the YouTube of the Chew. I've put a little inline fuel filter in. A little inline fuel filter there, because I'm not quite sure. I think the tank's going to be in good condition, but a few people have put it on just for good measure, so there you go. Right then, let's fire the bad boy up and see if it works. If he starts, I'm not going to leave him running too long, because it fills up with smoke here. It's with the way the wind is, this storm we're getting, or this windy storm, it's not drawing air out. Right then, switch is on, switch is off, petrol on. Right, bit of choke. First kick! Oh my god! Wow, first kick. Brilliant. Right, that's it then, folks. I'm going to tidy up now. I'm not going to do any more. I'm waiting for the new chain to come. Then I'll put the cover on and the new gear shift. I'll leave the fairing off because I've got a new air filter coming. I think that's coming tomorrow. I'm going to drop that in. Well, I'm not going to be here tomorrow, but I'll drop that in next week. When I'm back, the new wing mirrors have arrived. I have to take the fairing off to fit those. But I've got a Christmas present which needs that coming off anyway, so I'll fit those when that arrives. Other than that, that's it. I'm really chuffed that it started first time. It conked out because of obviously no fuel, but then it picked up again, and wow, brilliant. First kick, bingo, bango. I reckon that's down to my amazing mechanic and skills, the quality Lifan engine, and the iridium spark plug, and quality fuel, of course. Right then, folks, I hope you found that useful. Well, I hope you have. One thing I have forgotten to mention while I'm here, putting the glasses back on, I bought this little set of wire brushes off Amazon, and that is, well, this one particularly, well, I haven't used anything else, just this one, that has been so handy cleaning up some of the knackered, not knackered threads, but the really crappy bolts with the crap on the threads, give them a clean up. So this, I think it was about less than 10 quid delivered, well spent, really, really good, sir. Right then, without further ado, I'm going to get tidied up and go and have me a cup of tea. Right, until the next random content, I'm not going to do a video fitting the bloody shock. I'd like to think the next video is me. Come corn boy. Third time lucky. Fucking tidy. Right then, you know the drill. Like, subscribe, drop a comment. If you've got anything to say about the Honda or what I've done right or what I've done wrong, please, I want to learn. And new year, we'll get him taxed and insured, and then fingers crossed, once the engine's running, I'll go cruising with Mark Collingwood's brother Justin, because he's got one of these, and a man's bike as well. Not that that's not a man's bike, that's a proper man's bike, this one. Anyway, all right, until the next one. In a bit, peeps. Oh, and Merry Crimbo, if you've had it or you've what, I don't know. Anyway, in a bit.